Hi there, and thanks for purchasing How to Sing, a survival guide. This is Side A. By the end of these five lessons for the road, you'll be able to confidently answer, "Yes, I'm a singer," in any situation where a singer might be needed. We'll cover the basics from breath and intonation and go deeper into your mind to find the answers to questions such as, why singing? What does good singing even mean? Can I make money with my art? Let's dive in. Here are some important things to consider before you start. Number one, make mistakes. That's right. You need to be able to make mistakes. How easy does that sound? Go on, try it. Make a mistake right now. Any mistake. Did you make one? If you didn't make a mistake, technically that's also a mistake. So congratulations, you win either way. And that's what's important, the sense of being okay with mistakes, as long as you learn from them. No one ever woke up and just started singing perfectly. Not even Mariah Carey herself. So now that we've learned how to be okay with making mistakes, let's move on to tackling another important topic before we get started singing. Let's talk about why. Yes, the why is super important because it's the motivator for everything you do. Why singing? Why not cooking or technology or medicine or sports? Why is singing the one thing that will save you? This is a survival guide, after all. Now, the answer may not come to you immediately, but keep this question alive, and over time, see if you can develop a strong sense of why, and let that inform your work. For now, let's go with a general assumption that you want to sing because you enjoy it. And maybe because you want to impress your friends or seduce someone. Okay, one more thing before we start singing. It's important to find your influences. Find your roots. Now, this can mean physical, spiritual, cultural, familial, whatever you want it to mean. But it's important to ground yourself. Pause tape here. Find your roots. What does that even mean?
My mother never dressed in style. She said she'd rather be a guy. She could drive a stick shift. She redid our kitchen cabinets. There was nothing ever in her way. Nothing but her own damn games. The one she never wins. She's got a gambling problem, but she's smart and knows when it's time to stop. I wish I could deal her a winning hand. Am I the man she wanted me to be? Through whom she sings vicariously.
Great job! Did you find your roots? What did you find? For our next lesson, think back to when you were younger. What types of music were you surrounded by? What songs did you sing that maybe your parents also sung or at least knew of? Folk music? What is folk music anyway? What if you're from somewhere that was colonized by several different nations? Then what is folk music supposed to sound like? How many roots can you have? Let's acknowledge what you grew up with. Think back on those long road trips, just like this one, with so much time left until you arrive, wherever you're going. What music did you listen to in the car as you drove along the great highways of America? Country music? Rock? Disco? Why don't we try singing a song in a style that feels natural and authentic to you, whatever that may be? This is an exercise in letting go of your ego, being unafraid to make mistakes, and tapping into what your true sound is. Go for it. Go on. Just go. Pause tape here. Well, look at you. You're singing already, and we haven't even gotten into technique yet. The trick is, you probably already know how to sing. It's more about building the confidence to just do it. That's sometimes the hardest part. Confidence. Oh, I almost forgot. Speaking of confidence, something that can help us be braver when singing is to have someone special to sing to. For our next lesson, let's think about who this is for. Now, this might be someone you're trying to impress, or maybe a close friend or family member who can give you honest opinions. Let's go with a family member for now. How about a sister? Do you have a sister? If you don't, we could just make one up. Sing a song for your sister. Go on, just do it. Now, I know what you're thinking, but wait, we haven't even started to learn how to actually sing. Not to worry. Here is your very first bit of advice. Breathe.
Jenny, will you go to Tennessee? Jenny, is it really you and me? We drove you from Vermont to Canada.
So right now we're in the middle of my show, and I thought it would be good to give people context for what the last number is, because it's kind of hard to explain. Do you remember that time that mom just like drove off to the middle of nowhere and like didn't let anybody know where she was or where she was going or how to contact her?
Yes.
How was that for you?
I mean, I was a little stressed out just because I was worried, but at the same time, I was kind of, I was happy for her that she was just going out and doing something like that.
Okay, but she was gone for how long, though?
Probably a week or two.
Right, we knew that she was going to Oregon, but we didn't have, like, an address of, like, where or any way to get in touch with her because her phone was off.
I don't know if it was off or maybe she just wasn't getting signal, but yeah, she was basically just stopping at campsites.
Like that one time that we went to Australia, remember? And we just like drove with no sort of agenda. And like, remember when we slept on this literal side of the road?
But do like, you remember when we slept in that bathroom?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. It was like a bathroom, like outside, and there were like animals and bugs, and I think that plan lasted. I think it lasted about 5 minutes. That plan. So that whole time of mom just like driving off, going in the middle of nowhere, is what like prompted this like show for me, because it was like the first time that I felt like, oh wow, like, she could actually be dead, or like, and if she did die, there's so many things that I would have wanted to say and do, you know, and one of them was to like get her story down. I feel like this spirit of adventure and just recklessness is something that she passed down to maybe both of us. If you could drive this digital car to anywhere in the world, where would you drive it to?
I would love to go back to Australia.
Ooh, nice. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Well, maybe we'll take this this blue beetle and go to Australia.
Yeah. Might not come back.
And might not come back. All right. Well, I love you, and thank you.
I love you too.
Let's wave bye. Let's say, see you in Australia on three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. See you in Australia.
You're
Welcome to How to Sing, a survival guide, Side B. By now, you've found your roots, acknowledged your upbringing, built some confidence by singing in your true sound and style, and you've felt the urgency and intimacy of singing to someone special. Great job! For our next lesson, let's get specific. What is a vivid memory you have of something that left a lasting impact on you? This can be something that made you very angry or very sad or extremely joyful. What important event brings up these types of heightened emotions? After all, why would anyone want to sing about, slices of bread, for instance, or mowing the lawn? Think about how singing has evolved as a tool for survival. We want our stories to survive, and sometimes they live better in songs. We sing to the gods and pray for our survival. It's pretty high stakes. So let's sing about this specific event. For your survival.
Mama, don't drive away without your phone on. Mama, you said you'd stay a long, long while. When you get there, how will I know if you made it alright? You've been driving so long. Say we start all over. I'll call you each day and we'll talk for hours and hours. You can get an unlimited plan, 'cause you know we'll be talking so long about how so much has changed since then. Got a lot of catching up to do. What do you see out there on Highway 101? Lonely out there, 'neath the stars in Oregon. What do you do when you reach the end of the map? Come back.